Ziprasidone is an atypical antipsychotic used to manage schizophrenia, bipolar mania, and agitation in patients with schizophrenia. In this video, let's find found. What is ziprasidone? What class of drug is ziprasidone? What is ziprasidone used to treat? Who cannot use ziprasidone? What are the side effects of taking ziprasidone? How does ziprasidone make you feel? How to use ziprasidone? What is ziprasidone? What class of drug is ziprasidone? Ziprasidone, sold under the brand name Geodon among others, is an atypical antipsychotic used to treat schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. It may be used by mouth and by injection into a muscle. The IM form may be used for acute agitation in people with schizophrenia. Ziprasidone was approved for medical use in the United States in 2001. The pills are made up of the hydrochloride salt, ziprasidone hydrochloride. The intramuscular form is the mesylate, ziprasidone mesylate trihydrate, and is provided as a lyophilized powder. In 2020, it was the 282nd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 1 million prescriptions. What is ziprasidone used to treat? In its oral form, ziprasidone is approved for the treatment of schizophrenia, as monotherapy for acute treatment of manic or mixed episodes related to bipolar I disorder, and as adjunctive therapy to lithium or valproate for maintenance treatment of bipolar I disorder. The inhalable formulation is approved only for treatment of acute agitation in schizophrenia. Who cannot use ziprasidone? Besides hypersensitivity reactions to ziprasidone or any formulation excipients, there are several contraindications listed below. Patients with a known history of QT prolongation, including congenital long QT syndrome. Patients with uncompensated heart failure. Patients with recent acute myocardial infarction. Patients taking medicines that have demonstrated QT prolongation, including class IA and 3 antiarrhythmics, dofetilide, sotalol, quinidine, thioridazine, misoridazine, chlorpromazine, pimazide, droperidol, sparfloxacin, moxifloxacin, gadafloxacin, halofantrin, pentamidine, mefloquine, arsenic trioxide, levomethadil acetate, dolacetrin mesylate, probucol, or tacrolimus. What are the side effects of taking ziprasidone? Ziprasidone, and all other second-generation antipsychotics, SGAs, received a black box warning due to increased mortality in elderly patients with dementia-related psychosis. Sleepiness and headache are very common adverse effects, greater than 10%. Common adverse effects, 1 to 10%, include producing too much saliva or having dry mouth, runny nose, respiratory disorders or coughing, nausea and vomiting, stomach aches, constipation or diarrhea, loss of appetite, weight gain, but the smallest risk for weight gain compared to other antipsychotics. Rashes, fast heartbeats, blood pressure falling when standing up quickly, muscle pain, weakness, twitches, dizziness, and anxiety. Pharmacodynamics. Ziprasidone is classified as a second-generation or atypical antipsychotic and is a dopamine and 5-HT2A receptor antagonist with a unique receptor binding profile. As previously mentioned, ziprasidone has a very high 5-HT2A/D2 affinity ratio. Binds to multiple serotonin receptors in addition to 5-HT2A, and blocks monoamine transporters, which prevents 5-HT and NE reuptake. On the other hand, ziprasidone has a low affinity for muscarinic cholinergic M1, histamine H1, and alpha-1 adrenergic receptors. How does ziprasidone work? The effects of ziprasidone are differentiated from other antipsychotics based on its preference and affinity for certain receptors. Ziprasidone binds to serotonin 2A, 5-HT2A, and dopamine D2 receptors in a similar fashion to other atypical antipsychotics. However, one key difference is that ziprasidone has a higher 5-HT2A/D2 receptor affinity ratio when compared to other antipsychotics such as olanzapine, quetiapine, risperidone, and aripiprazole. Ziprasidone offers enhanced modulation of mood, notable negative symptom relief, overall cognitive improvement, and reduced motor dysfunction, which is linked to its potent interaction with 5-HT2C, 5-HT1D, and 5-HT1A receptors in brain tissue. Ziprasidone can bind moderately to norepinephrine and serotonin reuptake sites, which may contribute to its antidepressant anxiolytic activity. Patients taking ziprasidone will likely experience a lower incidence of orthostatic hypotension, cognitive disturbance, sedation, weight gain, and disruption in prolactin levels, since ziprasidone has a lower affinity for histamine H1, muscarinic M1, and alpha-1 adrenoceptors. Half-life. The half-life of ziprasidone is 6 to 7 hours. How to use ziprasidone? Schizophrenia. 20 mg POQ12HR with food initially, may be increased every other day PRN, not to exceed 80 mg Q12HR. Periodically assess need for maintenance. Clinical trials have documented no added benefit as above 20 mg Q12HR. Acute agitation with schizophrenia. IM, 10 mg Q2HR or 20 mg Q4HR, not to exceed 40 mg per day. Use IM for up to 3 days, and switch to PO if continuing past this time. Bipolar eye disorder. Acute treatment of manic or mixed episodes, maintenance therapy as adjunct to lithium or valproate. Acute treatment, 40 mg POQ12HR with food initially, on day 2, may be increased if necessary to 60 to 80 mg POQ12HR. Adjust dose according to tolerance and efficacy within range of 40 to 80 mg Q12HR. Maintenance, continue at same dose at which patient was initially stabilized, periodically reassess need for maintenance therapy. Are there specific concerns about ziprasidone and pregnancy? Zip is considered a relatively safe antipsychotic for the fetus when used during pregnancy. It is a Category C drug, meaning that there is not enough research done to determine if the drug is safe for pregnancy. Safety data on ziprasidone remains insufficient for a quantitative safety evaluation. That's all the information about ziprasidone we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.